Hello everyone, welcome to my first Canva tutorial. So for our first video, I will show you how to make polyscape design. So for today, ang gagawin po natin ay ito ang apat na designs. Mukha po siyang complicated pero simple lang po yung paggawa niyan. So, I posted it on Canva Creative Group and a lot of you liked it and asked for a tutorial. So, without further ado, let's start with this first image. So, gawa lang po tayo na another page. Ayan. So, i-delete muna natin siya. You can choose any landscapes na gusto nyo. And since tayo po ay naka-free account, syempre, ang gagawin dun lang tayo sa free. Okay. Search lang po natin ay Misty Mountain. So, ayan. Hanapin natin itong okay. Pag nakita nyo po itong merong may mga crown, says pro, so hindi natin pwedeng gamitin yan kasi may bayad, hindi lang tayo sa libre. So ayan, choose lang po natin yung free and hanapin natin itong katulad niya. So ayan, drag po natin and drop. So meron na tayong background photo. Next is itong dalawang half circle. Then go to elements and find circle holder. So let's find okay. Ayun sila. So just drag and drop. Okay. Try to put them as close as you want, like that, and then resize it. But it depends on you if you want it to be much bigger than this or smaller. It still depends on your taste. And then find the next photo, which is this one. I think I like that photo. Okay, ito. Found it. Okay. Just drag and drop again here. For this effect, we are going to turn it 180 degrees. So, we'll make an effect of like an upside down effect, and alt and drop to create a new one and drop it on that photo holder. Okay, so we need to adjust these photos to make it look like they're one photo cut in half. So like that, and this one too. Okay, right, that one. So now we have our first effect, and then next we are going to make that transparent shadow behind this image. So what are we going to do is just alt and drag and adjust the size. Again, it also depends on how much you want it big or small. And then position backward and let's change the color to white. Okay. Okay, just And the other one, you can just copy this one. Okay, and flip 180 and rotate by. Okay, and to achieve this transparency, you need to click those two and click this one and change the transparency to 50. Depends on how you like it. Looking good. Okay, next one, we are going to choose this tree. I don't know what you call this one, but yeah, we need that one. Okay, and so let's go back to your likes. Another tip for if you're making your designs is to like if you're always using that image, you can like it and it will automatically add it on your like folder, so you won't have to search for it again and again and again. So here we're going to drag it again, resize. So just need to adjust it on the image like that, and then we are going to crop so it has the effect of it. Draw again, flip 180 and adjust on the other half circle, and here we go. And the last one we need is a straight line, so just the first one. Resize the thickness and draw again. Flip. Okay, this time it's 490 degrees and drag it at the center. And then, of course, you need to change this to white. And ta-da! You now have the first photo. That's it. Okay, so tapos na tayo dun sa una. Okay, dito naman po tayo sa pangalawa. Again, create a new page. Delete that photo again. And then, syempre, kukunin ulit natin yung same photo. Ganun lang. And then, drag. Ayun. Hindi siya nag-automatic. Let's drag it. Okay. Just adjust lang tayo. And, we're going to find this triangle and circle. And this small circle holder. So, wala siya dito sa ating likes. Hanapin natin siya dito sa likes. Ayun. Circle holder. So, let's find that circle. And then, ito. So, adjust natin siya. So, depende pa rin po sa inyo kung gano'ng kalaki ang gusto nyo. Ayan. Ito. Para sa akin, gano'n. Tsaka, para kunwari, para siyang mood. And then, that circle and triangle. So, ito siya. Drag and drop. And so, automatic na siya. Yeah. Always try to put them first at the center of your page. and then you can adjust it later kung saan sila gusto i-position like that. So again, depende pa rin po sa inyo kung gaano siya kalaki. So again, let's find this photos. Balik tayo sa likes, or you can search for Sunset Ocean po sa photo search box. And because para sa ating tutorial, naka-likes na siya. So, drag and drop na lang po natin. This one, para dun sa taas. And the one on the center. Nalagay tayo na kunwari ng paaraw. So, for this one, nakikita niyo po itong parang linya dito. Parang horizon niya. Let's try to match it with this photo. Like ganyan. Para kunwari, may counting illusion. And that one. Next. Is this one. So, dito na sa kabila. Again, try to match it. The horizon of this one. So ayan. And enter. So hindi ko na po makita kung nasaan yung photo na to. So iba na lang po ang dynamic ko. Ayan. So ay. Okay. So ayan na siya. So as you can see, parang meron siyang illusion na parang iisa lang silang beach, pero yung totoo tatlong photos talaga sila. And then let's add this details. Okay, it's this one, a dotted circle, and position back to back. Oops, hindi. That's for the beginning. And then the circle inside this one. So again, try to center it. Mm-hmm. So mukha na siya siya. Mukha na siya center. Okay. And there you have it. So tapos na po tayo dito sa ating second image. Dito na tayo sa third one. So as you can see, mukha po siyang complicated, pero kayang-kaya po natin yung gawin. So again, add a new page, delete, and find natin siya. Ayan. Adjust natin siya ulit. So, dahil naka vertical siya, adjust natin siya dito. So, ayan. Okay. So, if you want to find this photo, lagay niyo lang ay night sky. So ayan, hanapin nyo lang yung my Pasiti. So ayun, pero you can find anything naman po nun. You can use any starry sky landscape or something similar to this one. So next, we are going to find this photo holder. Again, tayo sa elements, circle holder, and let's find this half circle. Again, doon tayo sa free. this one, yeah, this one. So just put it there again, try to make it center, and then drag the same image. Pero syempre mag-flip muna tayo again. Yeah, flip and then drop. So as you can see, kita yung parang hindi sila match ng colors dito. Like kita pa rin yung parang transition ng blue. So ang gagawin po natin ay let's drag. So para ma-achieve natin yung parang smooth transition ng colors niya. So parang ganyan. So medyo itaas pa natin siya na konti. Okay, parang ganyan. So, mapapa natin. So if you look at it, so parang smooth lang siya. So okay na po yan para sa akin. Now let's get this triangle. So let's find the triangle elements and triangle. Hanapin po natin yung medyo manipis na triangle. Ayan. So again, try to put it on the center. Change the color into white. So ito na po yung mabusising gawa. Ang gagawin po natin ay ika-crop natin itong triangle sa center. And then again, copy, paste on the same side and drag. So it will make an illusion of one shape lang siya. Pero yung totoo, cut na siya sa half. And then we put the first half backward, and that's how you do that. So dito naman po tayo sa next triangle, inverted one. So ang gagawin lang po natin ay click, hold shift and click this one. Pwede nyo po siyang gawin first is you can duplicate this triangle, or you can hold shift and click on. So ganyan. So as you can see, may bago tayong effect, pero hindi po yan ang gagawin natin effect for today. Ang gagawin lang po natin ay we're going to flip. Yes po. Yan po ang skills na matututunan natin ngayong araw, ang mag-flip. So again, try to put it in the center. So and ayan. Tapos na. So as you can see, madali lang po siya, hindi po ba? Okay, so we're done with our third one. So dito na po tayo sa ating last image. So as you can see, mukha po siyang complicated compared to this one, pero madali lang po yan. So again, start with a blank page and find that photo. Okay, drag and drop, adjust. So ayan, and Kuhain po natin itong triangle holder. Kung wala po dito sa ating likes, just type triangle holder and click that one. So, make it center. So, ang gagawin po natin ay mas malaki yung nasa center. And then, alt and drag again to copy. And make it a bit smaller. And on the other side. So, dahil may pagka-usi tayo, kailangan pantay. Again. Flip. Pantay again. So, ayan. So, ang gagawin na lang po natin ay find another landscape photo or medyo mas green ng kaunti. So, let's find green mountain. So, gamitin natin to. This one na lang para may mas malaki yung clouds. So, put it in the center. Again. Make it like that. Siya yung pinaka-center. So, again, make that illusion of parang kasama din siya doon sa lines. Like, pag sinundo niyo itong lines ng mountain, so, kala mo, siya yung nasa gitna talaga. So, drag and drop again dito sa isa. And on the other side too. So, as you can see. And, again, use the same image. For this time, ipi-flip naman natin siya. So, kita natin. May ganyan one. And, flip. Yes po. Magpi-flip na naman tayo. Walang katapos ang pagpi-flip. And, put it on the top side. So, hindi siya na-flip. At dahil hindi siya na-flip, tayo na lang ang mag-a-adjust. Ayan. So, ganyan. So, delete natin ito. And as you can see, para siyang may illusion na iisa lang siya. So, ang gagawin natin ay click this both triangles, hold alt, and drop. So, lagay natin siya medyo malapit sa isa't isa. Ayan. So, meron na tayong effects. Ang gagawin na lang po natin ay so, gawin natin siya mas malaki. Okay. And try to make it forward. Ayan. So, ang gagawin naman po natin ay gagawa tayo ng another copy and make it much bigger than the first one. So, parang shadow effect ulit. Parang katulad dun sa First na ginawa natin, put it back and set the transparency to 50. Ayan. So as you can see, parang meron na siyang shadow effect. Okay. And as you can see, ayan, close up. So make it for the next 4 triangles too. Click. And then draw position backward. Transparency set to 50. Ayan. So, i-copy na lang natin siya dito sa isa. Okay. And this one too. Hold out. Copy. Oops. Okay. Para hindi nyo siya, para hindi nyo magulaw yung like katulad nito, magkakatabi sila. So, ang gagawin po natin ay click and then click this to na ayaw niya magalaw and make it lock. So, kahit anong gawin mo, hindi niyo po yan magagalaw. So, dito naman tayo sa isa. Again, position it backwards. Okay, backward again. Ayan. And set transparency to 50 again. So, ayan. So, position it to make it pantay. Alright. So, this one. Okay, copy to the other side, and voila! See, it has that transparent illusion. And now the last part is to add our triangle. Okay, go to elements and triangle. So as you can see, mas malaki yung triangle. Adjust the size. Okay, so that looks good. And change it to light again. So as you can see, kailangan yung triangle niya ay the bottom part should be visible and the top part should be from should be behind the big triangle. So, ang gagawin po natin dyan ay aayusin lang natin yung position. So, make it backward. Backward again. Okay, and then this bottom part, para maging visible siya, we need to crop it again, copy, again, copy, paste, then put it in place, and then crop. Crop this other half. So, enter. And there you have it. Gives you the illusion of overlapping triangles. And there you have it. If you have any comments or questions, just comment down below. Or if you're gonna make these designs, please do tag me on Facebook at the lettering goddess, or comment your finished design
on Canva Creatives Philippines.
Thank you.
So, I hope you had fun, and till next time, bye.